let's talk about the 5 movie series of Die Hard. Hello everyone, Legend Forever, and today I am going to be ranking all 5 Die Hard movies from the worst to the best. This was a recent request from one of my subscribers, so I thought, hey, why not? I will be re-ranking them when it comes to Christmas time, because the first one is a Christmas movie. We need to settle that debate. It is a Christmas movie. Second one, I think I'll say it's a Christmas movie too, because it takes place around Christmas, but we need to get that through our heads. It's a Christmas movie. The people who say that it is not, I'm just going to say this, you're not a fan of Christmas. Like, seriously. Let's settle that debate now. And anyway, now we're going to be talking about them from the worst to the best. I have some opinions on these movies, I could say. Not everyone will agree with them, but I do have one of the two most common rankings. So now with no more ado or any more stuff, let's get started in talking about the worst. So easily in last place is A Good Day to Die Hard. There is no excuse for how bad this film is. There is no way for me to say how awful of an action movie this is. This is the second worst action sequel of all time. This film is so offensive to the franchise and just unbelievably terrible. And once again, in a fifth film in a beloved franchise where we hadn't gotten we had gotten a bad film in one of those franchises, but still, for once again, in a fifth film, we get an actor like Jai Courtney. And he once again manages to destroy the franchise and the legacy. And, it is just so bad. There's so many problems with this movie. I can say that I like it because it's rated R. That's all I'm going to say I like about it. Nothing else. Because Bruce Willis, you could tell he does not want to be here. I wouldn't be surprised if they had to, like, legally force him into this or blackmail him into this. Because he looks like he's sleepwalking through this thing. He really does not want to be there. And also, just the fact is, they make it seem like a John McClane, who we love through these 4 movies, as he's one of the most iconic movie characters of all time. He manages to supposedly screw up a mission that they had been planning for 2 years. And so it makes John McClane come off as a screw-up. And his son keeps talking to him like he is a screw-up, calling him John. He should not be calling him John. It's his son. Call him Dad. And we don't like his son, not only because he's such a brat half the time, but because we don't like him because he is talking down to John McClane. And because we like John McClane, we obviously don't like his son because he's so unlikable. He does nothing. They use some pretty over-the-top action sequences like Gone is Live Free or Die Hard's like almost like a bit over-the-top, but kind of cheesy and fun over-the-top. Like, now they're jumping out of buildings, surviving, jumping out of helicopters, jumping out of more buildings. They are doing stuff that they should not be able to getting away with. The villain reveal, awful. Like, this is a really bad movie. One of the worst movies ever made. And I can obviously put this one in last place and say that this film is awful. At number 4 is Live Free or Die Hard. I'm just going to say this right now. I'm going to say it. There is a humongous gap between A Good Day to Die Hard and Live Free or Die Hard. And the sense is, I really enjoy this movie. I think it's fun. It gets a lot of hate. I was one of the haters at first. I was like, wow, this movie is so boring. And I found it really difficult to finish. And then I watched A Good Day to Die Hard, and I kept turning it off every time I turned it back on, postponing it. So this film is nowhere near as bad, and John McClane feels a bit almost like a former shadow of himself. He doesn't feel like the John McClane we see in the other 3 movies. Like, I don't know if we needed a 4th movie. This could have just been a trilogy, because if this was just a trilogy, it would have been one of the great trilogies of all time, because I love this. I love all the next three. I really love because this movie, I can definitely say John McClane's now becoming an unstoppable Terminator in this movie. He's doing some stuff that as a old man he should not be able to do. He's even commenting on it. And, like, the fact is, he, and also there's some pretty over the top stuff in here. Like, the fact is, he drives a car through a bridge and manages to shove it into a helicopter and destroy the helicopter. He jumps out in midair while the car is going towards the helicopter and still survives. Like, this guy is surviving so much. And, I mean, I really enjoy the movie, don't get me wrong. But also, I think that it doesn't really understand what a Die Hard movie needs to be. It needs to be a hard R action movie with violence and good language. Even A Good Day to Die Hard, for how unbelievably terrible that movie is, I can still say it delivers on its F-bombs and its violence and gore. This movie, it doesn't really know, it's not really taking seriously the fact that when we go to a Die Hard movie, we want...
Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker.
And we do not want...
Elba! Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker!
Yeah, we don't want censoring when McClane gets to say his F-bombs. Because that's his trademark. Would you want to be censored? Wait a minute. Okay, never mind. But anyway, like I was saying, this film is... I can definitely say it's over the top. It's over the top. But I can enjoy some stuff about it because it's definitely a taco movie. I enjoy it way more than I should. But it's very consumable, and it's definitely way better than the film below it. Bringing us into the top three is Die Hard 2, Die Harder. And I also enjoy this one way more than I should because there's some moments in here that I can definitely say even Live Free or Die Hard probably has the upper hand on. But the reason I would put this movie above it, it's rated R. And also the quality I think is a tiny bit better. But I would say that I like Die Hard 2, Die Harder a tiny bit more than Live Free or Die Hard. Actually, I'll go more than a tiny bit, like a good size bit, a decent amount. But this film is also really good. But the fact is, the reason I won't put it higher is because you watch Die Hard on Christmas. Then you watch Die Hard 2, and it feels so similar with, like, the beats they follow and how the guy that McClane's wife punches in the first movie is now on the same plane as her. And just all these, like, similarities and plot beats, and it feels so much like the original, so it feels like a rehash. Just nowhere near as good. Because if people want to watch a Die Hard movie, they go to the original every time. Every single dang time, they're going to go to the original. No one is going to go to the second one when they have the option to watch the first. So it feels definitely a big drop in quality from the first one because it's following a lot of the same premises. The villain here, nowhere near as memorable as Hans Gruber. The setting here feels, like I said, a rehash and how McClane's having to save some people that are hostages from terrorists that are going to be, well, technically in the first movie, they were not terrorists. They were pretending to be terrorists. But, okay, we're moving on that. But I'll just say it feels kind of like a rehash. Believe me, I enjoy the movie. I do. I know that there are people that say that this film is not as good as Live Free or Die Hard. I've always been more partial to this movie, mostly because I have this, like, ability to predict my ranking movies before I see them, which is kind of odd because I probably should not be doing that, but I just do it, and pretty much all the time it comes out completely right. Like, I think I did it for the Expendables movies, I did it for Die Hard, I'm trying to think, what was the other franchise? I think I did it for Terminator. Yeah, I think I did it for Terminator 2. Actually, no, I think I said Genesis was going to be the worst, so I got proved wrong on that part, but Genesis was also really bad. But this is easily a movie that gets really a lot of hate, but because you're comparing it to the original. But believe me, I still have a lot of fun with this movie, and it is easily better than the films below. Well, not for Live Free or Die Hard, not easily, but it's definitely better. But it's a lot better than A Good Day to Die Hard. Sorry, I'm going to be cracking on that film every single time I can get a chance. Our runner-up is Die Hard with a Vengeance. And I know some people, like my dad, who, like, he hates this film. Like, he said that this one's his least favorite. Although, he also bought the fifth one, so that's how I watch these movies. He bought all the movies. But I don't think he saw the fifth one because, he said that maybe the fifth one's his least favorite, but I think that the fifth film was so bad that whenever he first watched it, which was probably a while ago, that he was like, no, I cannot finish this movie and forgot about it. So that might be one of the reasons this one's his least favorite, because he kind of gave up on the fifth one because it was so bad. It's definitely too bad to finish. That's perseverance, in my opinion. Like, good job, man. Thank you very much, man. Because that is persevering through such a bad movie like that. But Die Hard with a Vengeance, it definitely feels, it has some similarities to the original, in which McClane's definitely in over his head a lot more than he is in probably the other films. And also, we're getting Hans Gruber's brother in this movie, which is why he's trying to kill McClane. I don't think it was anything to do with Hans, because I think he even admitted that he was that he did not like his brother. I have no idea why. That's one of the reasons I criticized it. His schemes never really arrive about why he wants to get McClane, because he says that he also thought that his brother was a pretty bad person, that he did not like him at all, but he also seems to have some sort of vendetta against McClane for, like, no reason. So basically, even though your son, that's the thing why I'm saying son, because when I first heard that the bad guy's last name was Gruber, I assumed that Hans had a son, so it was his son. That would have made a lot more sense, but somehow, even though you thought that your brother was a jerk and someone that you did not like, you still have a vendetta against the guy that kills him. That makes literally no sense. And I'll say that this is the worthy successor to the original. And it's nowhere near as good. This is a terrible film when you compare it to the original. But there are people that say that this is better than the original. Not even close. Not in the slightest. Not gonna happen. But I will say that the first two acts are very clever, and when they're doing, like, the riddles, especially, like, the water one, that one's super complicated, but, like, then when you get to the, actual robbing of the thing, I think that's when it starts to slow down, and I don't know, I think it was kind of underwhelming the way they have to kill off Simon, because they were running out of time, so they, like, kind of immediately have a big rush through it, like, it feels a bit rushed. So, I'm not gonna fully say it's good. Zeus is a good character in this movie, too. He's one of my favorite characters in this franchise. But I can definitely say that it has some problems, but it also is definitely the one that I would say is closest to the original, while not being even close to the original. But without question, no doubt about it, with ease, no question, the original Die Hard is still the best in the franchise. This is the perfect action movie, perfect movie, perfect just Christmas movie. This is everything that you want in a movie. Like, we don't get classics like this anymore. Like, it is just so unbelievable. Like, the fact is, we don't get movies like this anymore that are just so brilliant. And it is so good. It created its own subgenre of action movies that have been ripped off so many times. And this movie is so iconic. It's probably the most quotable movie ever made, where there's just so many great moments like the yippee-ki-yay, mother. I'm not going to finish that part because I'm not going to finish that part. And also, whether you have line, you have so many other really quotable lines, like, now I have a machine gun. Ho, ho, ho. Like, this movie is just so amazing, and they took a chance casting Bruce Willis, who was not a good actor at the time. Like, he had not been in very many things. I think he had only been in, like, one show. No movies. They cast him. He rises to the A-list. He immediately, he takes off. John McClane, like, one of the greatest movie characters of all time. So clever, yet so relatable. Like, he doesn't want to save the day. He's a reluctant hero, and he's in over his head. Hans Gruber, like, he's my favorite villain of all time. Heath Ledger's close, but I find that he has more charisma. Heath Ledger delivers the better acting performance, but I think that Hans has more charisma to him. And there's just so much that this film does. But I'm also going to talk about the bad. well, couldn't think of anything, so... But anyway, this is just the perfect action movie. Perfect movie. It delivers everything you want in an action movie, and... While many films copied its terms and even its poster, it still has not managed to deliver. It still has not managed to deliver a successor that has managed to beat it. No film has ever managed to rise above it, except for one, which is Terminator 2, Judgment Day, and on some days, maybe Aliens. Right now, I'm preferring Die Hard to Aliens, but believe me, they're close. But Die Hard, oh, just such a breath of fresh air. And this is, the fact is, it's not even Bruce Willis's highest rated movie on IMDb, which is Pulp Fiction, which makes no sense. I haven't seen Pulp Fiction, even I know. It's not a Die Hard level. Is it as quotable as Die Hard? I don't think so, but I do hear it's pretty quotable. But also, which one is the smarter film? That might be Die Hard. I mean, Quentin Tarantino, he's a good director, but still. Like, this is John McTiernan at his best. He also directed Predator, which I know a lot of people would say is a superior film. Die Hard all the way. And it just feels so amazing. This is the quintessential movie. Like, this is the movie you must watch before you die. Like, if you're on your deathbed, this is the movie that you will want to watch. This is a must-watch for people who have not seen too many movies. This is a must-watch. And it easily would come into first place in this ranking. There you have it, guys. There's my ranking of all 5 Die Hard movies. Make sure that you share your ranking of all of them in the comments below if you have seen them. If not, then just let me know if you should watch the Die Hard movies. I can easily recommend which ones you should watch. I think we all know which one that you need to make a priority to watch, but... Anyway, talk about something related to Die Hard in the comments below. We can have a good discussion. And also, I just recently got Letterboxd. So if you want to follow me on there, that would be great. But you don't have to if you don't want to. And also, make sure to subscribe if you're not already. Because on the 29th, I have a big superhero ranking coming up with my buddies, Film Kid, Hasta La Vista Baby, and Jay Lewis. All of us participate in a massive ranking, so be sure not to miss out on that amazing event. Thank you all so much for watching this, and have a good one.